From Vandenberg Air Force Base in Central California, you're watching live launch coverage of NASA's interior exploration using Seismic Investigations, Geodesy, and Heat Transport, or InSight spacecraft, to study the interior of Mars. Hi, I'm Stephanie Martin, and thanks for joining us. NASA's InSight mission is the 20th mission to Mars. Previous missions have taught us a lot about the planet's surface, atmosphere, and ionosphere. InSight, however, will teach us about what goes on a mile or even 2,000 miles below the surface. This will help us understand how rocky planets like Mars and Earth were formed and why the two planets are so different 4.5 billion years later. Today, we have team coverage from NASA's Joshua Finch, Tori McClendon, Blair Allen, Chris Gersh, and Franklin Fitzgerald, who are with launch teams across the Air Force Base. InSight is flying on United Launch Alliance's Atlas V 401 configuration and has a 2-hour launch window starting at 4:05 this morning Pacific Time or 7:05 Eastern Time. This means that launch teams have 2 hours to lift off from Space Launch Complex 3 at Vandenberg Air Force Base. InSight is set to land on November 26th in the Elysium Planitia region of Mars, which is about 373 miles from the Gale Crater, where NASA's Curiosity rover touched down in August 2012. After InSight lands, it will spend 728 days, or a little over a Martian year, studying the planet's interior. InSight will be the red planet's first thorough checkup since it formed 4.5 billion years ago. InSight will take the vital signs of Mars, specifically its pulse, its temperature, and its reflexes. After the spacecraft's roughly 6-month journey to Mars, it will begin its landing phase. InSight enters the Martian atmosphere traveling at 13,200 miles per hour and deploys its parachute and ultimately slows down to about 5 miles per hour for touchdown. 1 minute later, InSight will begin its surface operations, checking out the lander's health indicators and then deploying its solar arrays. It will take about 10 weeks to place all the instruments on the ground. About 7 weeks later, it will sink its self-hammering heat probe about 10 to 16 feet into the Martian soil. There are also two briefcase-sized CubeSats, known as Mars Cube 1, or MARCO, hitching a ride on today's mission as a part of a NASA technology demonstration mission. MARCO A and MARCO B will deploy from the second stage of the Atlas V about a minute after InSight separates and will then fly toward Mars. We are now about 30 minutes away from today's launch. Let's check in with NASA's Joshua Finch in the Mission Director Center for a status on today's launch and a weather update. Josh?